As we know, Holi is coming, so today I'm gonna make Holi special, a very famous Punjabi snack called the samosa. And it's also very popular on the streets of India. Samosa is something we all usually make at home, but today I'm gonna show you my take on the street style, and it's going to be super yum.
Welcome back to my YouTube channel Resma's Kitchen. Today I baked with a new recipe and I hope you will like it. And if you like my video, please do like, comment, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel Resma's Kitchen. And also hit the bell icon so that you will get notifications of all new videos. So without any wasting of time, let's get started.
First of all, we'll make dough for the samosa. For that, here I have 3 cups of plain or refined flour. Now I'm gonna add 1 teaspoon of carom seeds to it. We'll put 1 teaspoon of salt. Now we'll give it a good mix by hand. Now I'm going to add 1/4 cup of oil to it. You can also use ghee if you want to. Now going to rub the oil with the flour really very well. It's called short crust method. Take a little bit of this flour and press. It forms that shape. It looks perfect. Now we'll add in little water at a time, form this to a strip dough. Make sure you don't add lot of water, then the samosa won't get as crispy as you want to be. Here you can see the dough is formed. This is a very stiff dough. Now we'll coat the dough with oil. Now I'm gonna cover it and keep this for about 1 hour to rest. Now we'll make stuffing for the samosas. For that I'm gonna add in about 3 tablespoons of oil to it. Now we'll put 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1 teaspoon fennel seeds, and we wait for it to crackle. After crackling, we'll put 1 tablespoon crushed ginger garlic, 2 to 3 chopped green chili. We'll fry it for few seconds. Now I'm gonna add spices one by one. Begin by taking 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1 tablespoon coriander powder, 1 tablespoon garam masala, and we'll give it a stir to avoid letting the spices burn. Now I'm gonna put 1/2 cup of boiled green peas. Mix it with all the spices. Now we'll put 2 teaspoons of salt or according to your taste. Mix it well. Now I'm gonna add in the potatoes to it. These are about 8 potatoes, boiled and roughly mashed by hand. We'll give it a good mix. Now I'm gonna add some chopped coriander leaves and some dry fruits. Dry fruits are totally optional. If you don't like, you can skip it. Again, give it a good mix. The masala looks absolutely ready to me, and I'm gonna get this down to a plate now. So the dough has well rested. Now I'm gonna take off the cloth and again knead this dough for about a minute. This is good enough for now. I am going to divide this dough into 2 portions. Take the first portion and divide into parts. Here I have my dough portion and I am going to roll it. So I have rolled it out to an oblong sheet. The thickness of the chapati should be so. Now I'm going to cut it in 2 parts. So I'm to keep a portion aside. Here I have some water and I'm gonna dip my finger in it. And we'll apply on the hard portion of the samosa. And where the straight line is, which is going to fold it into half. And make a cone. And nicely seal it up. Overlap it properly and seal up the edges properly. Here I have a cone over here which is ready. Now I'm gonna fill my filling into it. So make sure you press it all down so that it does not have an empty spot. Don't fill it up till the top because we need the edges to stick and seal the samosa. Now we'll apply a little bit of water on the edges. And now I'm going to do is take a pinch and stick it together. Now we'll stick the edges together. Now here you can see my samosa is ready. Now we'll keep it in a plate. Similarly, we'll make rest of the samosas. Guys, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please subscribe and give thumbs up if you like the video. Here you can see I have prepared all the samosas. Now these are ready to fry. So here I have oil heating up and the oil is warm. Now I'm gonna add the samosas to it. Here you can see the oil is warm, not too hot. And here no bubbles are seen. So at low to medium flame, let them fry slowly. And remove it out like when it's like golden brown. It's really superb and mouth-watering recipe, friends. Once try it out and I damn sure you will love this. We are almost there, it's fried to golden. Now I'm frying it for just a minute more. And then we have to take it out to the plate. Here you can see my samosas are fried. Now I'm gonna take them out now. Now you can serve them hot with green and red chutney. So our perfect Punjabi style samosa is ready and it's absolutely flavorful, much better than stir fried. I must say guys, once try it out and let me know how it goes for you. Then guys, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please subscribe and press the bell icon as well so that you get the new video notifications first. I hope to see you soon with one more recipe. Thank you so much for watching. Till then, take care and bye bye.